This video will explain how metabolism occurs within the fetus and how this leads to acidemia. First, let's look at aerobic metabolism. In utero, a fetus is supplied with the oxygen from the placenta. Fetal blood has a high oxygen-carrying capacity due to its increased affinity of fetal hemoglobin to oxygen, which is where oxygen is carried. The fetus takes this oxygen and combines it with glucose to create energy. The byproducts of this are carbon dioxide and hydrogen ions. A fetus has a supply of buffers. These capture the hydrogen ions and prevent them from having an effect on the pH of the blood. The carbon dioxide is transported back to the placenta to be transferred to the maternal blood and be expelled. During normal labour, as the uterus contracts, there will be a disruption in gaseous exchange at the placenta. This means that less carbon dioxide is removed and less oxygen is available to the fetus. However, as the fetal hemoglobin has a high affinity for oxygen, it can meet its needs. But the amount of carbon dioxide removed will be reduced. The carbon dioxide will start to accumulate in the fetus. This is respiratory acidemia. A fetus is designed to cope with this and has enough buffers to prevent the hydrogen ions from affecting the pH of the blood and therefore causing cell damage in the brain or heart. When there is a significant or prolonged reduction in available oxygen at the placenta, for example caused by placental insufficiency or ileocecal compression, then issues start to occur. The fetus still needs to create energy, but now needs to do so without oxygen. This is known as anaerobic metabolism. Anaerobic metabolism is the production of energy from glycogen without the need for oxygen, which is a less efficient way to produce energy, and the amount of hydrogen ions produced to obtain the same energy is far greater. As there are more hydrogen ions produced, more buffers are needed to prevent them affecting the pH of the blood. Prolonged anaerobic metabolism continues to produce larger quantities of hydrogen ions, meaning the buffer stores are used up quicker. Eventually, buffers will be used up, and at this point, the hydrogen ions are left unbuffered in the fetal circulation and will begin to cause the pH of the blood to drop. This is known as metabolic acidemia. In order to cope with the lack of circulating oxygen, the fetus will stop all non-essential movements to redistribute the oxygenated blood to its vital organs. When gaseous exchange at the placenta is further impaired, for example due to regular uterine contractions, the fetus is put under increasing stress. They may attempt to reduce the workload on the heart, causing it to temporarily beat slower. This results in a deceleration of the heart rate, which we recognise as a chemoreceptor deceleration. Sustained regular contractions and the resulting impaired gaseous exchange at the placenta will cause these decelerations to become more prolonged, frequent and repetitive. In a further effort to cope with ongoing low oxygen levels or hypoxia, the fetus will next increase the heart rate to circulate the most oxygenated blood to the brain and heart. Up to this point, the fetus is working hard to cope and compensate with a hypoxic environment. Over time, if anaerobic metabolism continues, the fetal blood becomes acidic and starts to cause damage in the cells within the body, including the brain and myocardium. This damage is permanent. This decompensation may appear as reduced variability and eventually baseline instability as the fetal heart and brain no longer have enough oxygen to function and adequately control the heart rate. So in summary, aerobic metabolism is the combining of glucose with oxygen to create energy, with carbon dioxide and hydrogen ions as byproducts. Buffers act upon the hydrogen ions and prevent them from having an impact on the pH of the blood. The carbon dioxide travels to the placenta, where it's transferred to the maternal bloodstream to be expelled. If gaseous exchange is reduced at the placenta, carbon dioxide will begin to accumulate in the blood, which is known as respiratory acidemia. Anaerobic metabolism is the breakdown of glycogen without oxygen to form energy, with hydrogen ions being byproduct. These are produced in greater quantities, which leads to buffers being used up, allowing the hydrogen ions to be unbuffered in the blood, causing the pH to drop and cell damage in the fetus. This is known as metabolic acidemia.